like that, it's all on F2 though, right?
No, anything's in there, yeah, it'll give you the message and it'll come up there and it'll say,
and that's how you would press each F2 or something like that,
yeah.
To go to the next one and see if.
Yeah. Side one where you're controlled from the inside is called your APTO. And what that does, it's for moving the reel, it moves the box up and down, it'll move the door up and down, it'll turn the router pump on low gallonage. So that's the A side, and that comes on with the, just using the switch inside the cab. When you want to do, use this hose to rod, then you're going to go to mid or high range, depending on what kind of nozzle you'll have. And what you'll have is, put this one on, then what that does is it engages the second PTO, and the second PTO is for high flow. So when you engage the second PTO, you do that basically, and then, so what you do is you turn on your, let's do this. This has a low water alarm on it, so when you get down to about 150 gallons, it's going to drive you nuts. So all you do is sit there and hit this one, it will silence the alarm, and then you can use your 150 gallon without it blaring all over the place. So with the pump on, you have your throttle switch on, you'll sit there and increase your RPM to get your flow, and then use this to finish. This is your fine tuning, this will get you your pressure. So what you do is you dial this in, so this gets up to your 2000 PSI. And you're gonna see all this when you go take it across the street, we're gonna crank on, let everybody play with it.
So both switches got to be on anyway, and that's just switching the PTO right away before we start working anything.
The only one that's in there is the master. It turns on the PTO. Okay. So there's only one switch inside the cab. It's hit the master switch, and everything's ready. But this one here is going to control this function here, get enough water for this. If you're using the hand gunner, you're washing down at the end, you only need the low side, you dial this in. And it stops at about between 500 and 600 PSI. It's on its own relief, so it's not high enough pressure where you can hurt yourself or hurt the gun or anything else. So this is all set up. There's two separate reliefs on there. One's a high pressure side for this, the other's a low pressure side for the hand. Basically what you'll have here, hose reel extender track. That allows you to move the hose reel away from the bumper. When you get ready to leave, you can put it back in against the bumper. Then here's your lock and lock so you can pivot it. It'll move 270 degrees.
Oh, wow.
And you have controls on both sides. Shit.
Explain why that's going off.
Low water alarm. It says we have less than 150 gallon in the tank, so it's going to go off and drive you nuts until you get out.
Okay.
So you can roll it 270 degrees. When you lock it, make sure the reel is stopped. Then lock it and give it a little push. Because what there is two air cylinders pushing some teeth in. And this hose reel is mounted on a big bearing that has teeth in it, so what you're doing is locking the gears up. So make sure you stop it and then lock it. Then this one here's for your pinch roller. So what you have, it puts 70 PSI down against this roll. So what that does is it keeps this reel, you know how the set will kind of roll and turn into a big mass? What that does is pinches down on it. So if you're still hanging on to it, somehow this stops and you're still hanging on to it, just have to throw it out instead of doing this to the bundle. It'll set them to tension on that. It has an auto wind guide. And so let's move this a little bit. If you have it like, you know, where this is over here and your hose is over here, you simply pull this out about a quarter inch and you can sit there and move it and put it back in line again.
So that's like your guider.
Yep. You run the hose through here, and it'll sit there and follow it, wind it back and forth by itself.
Keep it hose through here.
Mm-hmm. Okay, just like that, right, okay.
Yep. control. You see, everything has a house on it. All your controls, all your main switches have a house. So before you start out, you want to make sure everything's in the house. That's all you got to remember. If you don't, it's going to tell you. And what I'll do is I'm going to go inside and I'm going to mess this all up, and then I'll show you what it does. It's not going to let you start in an unsafe condition. So give me a second here. I'll sit there and mess it all up, and then we'll straighten it up again so you can start it. Run it, your PTO won't engage.
Now, is the PTO in the truck?
The master switches, yeah.
But that's always got to be on.
That's, I always got to hit that when you're ready to work. I got to put that on for you.
Set of messages up here. So what it does is says PTOB has been disabled during start because you're not supposed to start with PTOB engaged. So you move this back, it's in the house. Okay. The throttle on off switch on the front panel is left on. That's this guy.
Oh, look at that.
Back in the house. Okay. The vacuum enable switch. We're always start without vacuum and you add vacuum to it. So here, you gotta put it back in the house. Okay. Router pump switch, somebody left the water on. It's not gonna let you do anything until you turn the water off. Hit the switch. Okay. Front or rear e-stop is pushed in, so you gotta go check them both. Check the front side. Check the back side. Okay. Side e-stop is pushed in. Up in the back, three e-stops. On the front of the reel, on the back of the reel, one in the toolbox. I'll shut the one off in the toolbox. See that? Okay. No more messages. So we can start, we're ready to run.
So if anything's like that, it's all on F2 though, right?
No, if anything's in there, yeah, it'll give you the message and it'll come up there and it'll say,
and that's okay. How you would press each F2 or something like that.
Yeah.
To go to the next one if you...
Yep. So if you have multiple messages, you'll have multiple F2s on there. And it'll sit there and it'll throw that out at you and just keep on banging through it until your screen is clear. So that's the first thing you notice. If it isn't going to start right away, look for a message. All right. We went over these controls. This is your main router valve. Open this, lets that water go into that, open through the main hose. What we always start out with is we always leave the hand and one open. So if somebody does accidentally hit this, all it's going to do is take the water, go through the 600 pound relief and go back to tank. So you're not going to get sprayed in the head. So if I'm getting ready to set up on a hole, what I'll do is turn this valve on first and walk over to the side, turn the handgun valve off so now everything's directed here. So here's our handgun valve. This would be in the on position. We try to turn this one off.
So it'll be off.